Scorpio, welcome to my channel. This is Chelsea. Thank you so much for liking and subscribing. I really appreciate your love and support, and I hope all is well with everyone. Today we are going to do a general reading. You can apply this reading to your love, career, friendship, or family situation. Please bear in mind that this is a general reading again, and it may not apply to each and every one of you. Alright, Scorpio, let's get your reading started. Spirits and angels, please show me important, accurate general reading, general messages for Scorpio today. I don't know why. Can't shuffle. Show me more. Okay, let's see. The High Priestess here indicates intuition, secrets, but also I feel like Scorpio Spirit is trying to help. It's trying to tell you to always use your intuition, okay? More than your heart, intuition over your heart, because the King of Cups is in reverse right beneath the High Priestess. But also you got the King of Swords and the Page of Wands. You're going to be seeing something clearly eventually. If there's something that you feel like you can't see quite clearly, or that you can't make a decision yet, I feel like you are going to make a decision. And a decision, I feel that it's going to also involve some, may have something to do with passion or desire, or for some of you this may indicate business. I do see business traveling because of business, traveling because of work, okay? For some of you, Eight of Swords in reverse, and we've got the Ten of Swords here in reverse. I feel like Scorpio, you're gonna finally come to peace. To me, the High Priestess is balance. It's a balanced energy, but also very peaceful, okay? Looking into a matter very calmly, very peacefully. And if you're not doing that, Scorpio, I feel like this could be what the Spirit is trying to tell you to do, okay? I feel like also to keep calm and collected and to be more strategic with your plan, I feel like that will yield a much better results for you, okay? This can apply to you in love or in your career or friendship, family, okay? So we got the Ten of Pentacles here and with the Five of Cups. I feel like Spirit is also trying to tell you to see the glass half full than it is half empty, because you still, maybe if you can't see it yet, there's a Ten of Pentacles here. There's something in your future where I feel it's going to be a future that is very happy, very bright, and very stable. Ten of Pentacles indicates money. A lot of money, okay? Ten is not a completion number in tarot, so it's a lot of money. Also, it could indicate stability. It could also indicate inheritance or money that you could have worked really hard for. Getting married, if you're not married yet, if you're divorced, maybe you get married again. Starting a family, starting a blended family, even starting, you know, another thing I'm getting here is you don't, if some of you, if you haven't met this person yet, okay, you'll be meeting one person here that I feel both of you either will work together, or this person is a very good support system, okay? I always say this, if you choose the wrong partner in your life, no matter how much you love the person, no matter how much chemistry both of you have for each other, if you don't, if it's lack of these pentacles, lack of stability, I feel like it's harder to sustain, okay? Love is really not everything. So I feel like, Scorpio, if you're not doing this, maybe Spirit's trying to say, you know, instead of following your heart, because the King of Cups is in reverse here, instead of following your heart, mulling over the past here with the Three of Cups because of heartbreak or disappointment here, Spirit says it's to be more, to be more practical and logical towards the decisions that you want to make, because it looks like that way you can build something for your future that is more permanent. Ten of Pentacles can indicate permanence, or can indicate again long-term stability, a lot of money, happiness for me, Ten of Pentacles is the best card. If you want to ask questions in regards to business or love, it's still the best card for me, because this is the card that can sustain. This is the type of energy that has a long-term effect. So you can apply it however you like to. If it has something to do with love, perhaps searching for a partner. If you're searching for a partner, perhaps instead of thinking about, you know, following your heart or following your passion or your desire this time around, how about being more structured or constructive with the way you choose your partner? Okay, that's what I'm getting here. It may not apply to all of you. However, if this has something to do with your business or career, I feel like Spirit's definitely saying less is more. The High Priestess perhaps only say when you need to say, when it's necessary, because the High Priestess can indicate silence as well. And look into any matters very calmly, okay? Because this is when, again, you can make a better decision with the King of Swords here. A better and more of a form, intelligent decision, okay? So that's not going to apply to all of you, Scorpio, but I just thought that I would do something different since I keep doing love reading, so I'll like to put this into the mix. I hope you're enjoying it so far. So we got the Queen of Swords and the Magician here. So there is one person here, Scorpio again. This person may be a Libra, Gemini, Aquarius, can be any sign, Virgo, Capricorn, Taurus. I'm seeing here a little bit of a Pisces energy or water energy. Scorpio, I feel like you're going to meet somebody whom I feel both of you may have the same goals, okay? Both of you are very clear with what you want in life, what you see yourself in the future, having the same goals, same perspectives, same wants and same needs, okay? And Scorpio, if you haven't met this person, I feel like if you're not thinking this way, as in you're not sure if you should follow your heart or if you should just follow your desire or your passion, Spirit's definitely saying to follow your head, your brain, okay? I hope that makes sense to you. And to choose a partner according to them having the same goals as you are, and making things very clear, laying the cards out, and be completely transparent and honest with each other, as in with expectations, future expectations, all right? So we've got the Magician here. You can make that happen, all right? Scorpio says. The spirit says, sorry, I'm just looking at this card suddenly and I said Scorpio. But Spirit says you can make all of these things happen, actually. You just don't know how powerful, how talented you are, okay? You can make it happen. So we've got the Eight of Cups in reverse. And also we've got the Ace of Pentacles here in reverse. I definitely sense this is a little bit of a scolding energy. I don't want to scold you, Scorpio. I just feel like it's like this nagging. That's an energy of somebody like wanting to nag at you, okay? Nag you, as in like with the Eight of Cups in reverse and the Ace of Pentacles in reverse. It's like, forget about the past. That's what I'm getting, okay? Forget of what did not happen. You just gotta move forward. You just gotta move on, because you can't see this yet. It could be a spirit guide. It could be an angel, okay? But there is this message telling you, hey, you can't see this yet, this Ten of Pentacles. You will get this one, but if you still mull over the past, then it's gonna be really hard. Or there will be a delay of you achieving what you truly want in life. If it's career, it looks really good, Scorpio. A lot of stability, a lot of money. You can build an empire. You possibly will work with the person, your own partner, okay? Your own spouse. We got the Four Swords here, needing time to. Spirit's also saying that you need time to think, okay? Think. I hate to say this, but but it keeps saying don't follow your heart, okay? Just need to weigh things very logically, very practically. Use your intellect to judge, use your intellect to make your decisions, all right? Scorpio, this is your reading. Hope you resonated. If you did, please hit like, share, and subscribe. I'm gonna leave you with a video on the screen right now. The This is the video for my second vlog channel. If you're interested, check it out. And also, I'm open for personal readings. If you'd like to book me, my information is in the description box below. And Scorpio, I post your videos almost every single day. However, different timing. If you'd like to be notified every time when I post your videos, don't forget to hit on the bell notification button. All right, take care, Scorpio. Bye.